The CBS Radio Mystery Theater presents... I'm E.G. Marshall. The scientists tell us that to every action, there's an equal and opposite reaction. Or, on a practical basis, each time you take a step forward, there are those who try to push you a step back. Or even, on a more practical note, each time the police come up with a new and better way to catch a thief, the criminals create a new and better way to escape. Are we, as a late and great philosopher once suggested, on a treadmill to oblivion?
Tom, a man can't be a machine.
A man has to do his job.
But Tom, there are times...
A man has to be true to his oath, Doc.
But there are extenuating circumstances.
Never. Otherwise, the whole thing collapses. As an officer of the law, I'd bring in the person who committed a crime, no matter who it was.
Even if it were someone close to you?
Even if it were my own mother.
Our mystery drama, Private Stock, was written especially for the Mystery Theater by Sam Dan and stars Ian Martin. It is sponsored in part by Buick Motor Division. I'll be back shortly with Act One. Is it a gradual, integrated,
step-by-step
process of absorption? Do we acquire understanding in layers and by degrees? Or is it all revealed in one fantastic flash of insight, in a single searing stab of recognition? Well, all this is by the way of laying down the groundwork of our tale. And now that we have that out of the way... How about a little action?
I guess I'd better answer the thing, baby.
Forget it.
Okay. I'm easy to get along with. Now then again, if I don't answer, it'll ring all night.
Maybe they'll get tired and hang up.
Not this one. This is a stubborn cat.
Which cat? You know who it is?
No.
Then how do you know he's stubborn?
So, by the way, the phone rings.
Yeah? How can you tell?
Well, first, let me get rid of him. Call back later. Now, what was I talking about?
How you can tell what kind of person is calling you by the way the phone rings.
Oh, yeah. See, I had this guru. Very heavy. Deep.
Whatever happened to him?
He disappeared. He said, we transfuse our personality into the physicality of the ordinary everyday objects we touch.
Is that a fact?
There's the stubborn cat again. You see how the ring sounds? Nervous? Like the guy has no cool at all? Dig?
Dig.
Well, let's give him a break.
Why?
It's got to be a pal of mine.
You can tell by the ring...
Who else would have my unlisted number? Go ahead, it's your dime.
Hey, Lee, baby.
Hey, Chunky, is that you?
Oh, guilty, Your Honor, all the way.
Hey, man, I thought you were dead.
Why?
Because everybody's been saying such great things about you.
Well, I just got in from the coast.
You'll play the date?
Hey, you know what I forgot to do? Line up something for tonight.
Ooh, wow, old age is creeping up on you, son.
Oh, I thought I'd call my buddy here to see if you could find me some action, dig?
You dialed the right number.
Hey, you think I can get well?
I got just the medicine to turn that little trick, absolutely.
Where do I go?
Go, man. Service is our middle motto. You stay, we deliver.
Gotta be guaranteed merchandise.
Comes from our own private stock.
Hey, would it be the redhead?
Chunky, how would you know about the...
I got my spies. Soon, baby.
Ciao. And that was Chunky. The Chunky Chapman himself.
Boo.
What's boo?
I don't dig Chunky.
You don't dig Chunky?
In the first place, he's old enough to be my father.
Well, can a guy pick his time to be born?
In the second place, he looks like my father.
Well, shouldn't that give him a gold star?
I don't really like my father.
Oh, Ginny, that's un-American.
Yeah, I think it's quite possible. I even hate my father.
Well, I don't know your father, but...
That's it. I don't know him either.
Well, if you don't know him, how can you hate him?
Oh, I know him. Maybe I should have said he doesn't know me.
I think you got a weird relationship working there.
He doesn't know anybody except himself. He doesn't want to know anybody. He killed my mother.
You're putting me on.
No, not with a gun or anything like that. He just broke her heart.
Oh, from the song of the same name?
You know where my father thinks I am tonight? At a concert.
Then I better sing to you.
What am I talking about him for?
I got a better idea. Let's talk about you. And a favor you can do for me. Would you do it?
Lee, I'd do anything for you.
Look, it's getting late. Now, you know this concert your old man thinks you're going to. Well, it wouldn't be over till 11, anyhow, would it?
11:30.
So, you got more than enough time to do this little thing for me.
Okay, what is it?
Stop off at Chunky's hotel room.
Oh, well, sure. I heard what you said on the phone. You said you'd send him some medicine.
Right.
Well, I certainly don't dig the man. If he's a friend of yours and he's sick... I'd certainly bring him something to help him get well.
That's my redhead.
Where do I get the medicine?
It's right here in this room.
What is it?
It's you.
Me?
Mm-hmm. Just keep him company for a little while.
Me?
Baby, he's lonesome. He's got the blues so bad he could just die.
You're asking me to go to...
I'm asking you to save my life. Nobody in this world plays guitar like Chunky. Getting him to make this record date with me was like...
I didn't hear you say what I thought I did I?
I said I'd help him out, so if you don't go, he'll kill the date on me.
No.
No? What do you mean, no? Would it kill you to spend 10 minutes with Chunky Chapman?
Yes.
What am I asking you to do? Kill somebody? Hey... Jenny, you're on a downer tonight. Everything will look different in the morning. Chunky's a great guy to know.
Why?
Well...
Are you passing me off to Chunky? Is that it?
Look, we've got a beautiful relationship, a meaningful relationship. This will only strengthen it.
I love you, Lee. I love you.
Sure. And all I'm asking you to do is, prove it.
Don't ask me, Lee. Please. Don't ask me.
Listen, he's a million lads.
Please, Lee.
Come on, baby.
You really want me to go, don't you?
I told you, you'll be saving my life.
I don't think it's worth saving.
Really can't mean anything to you.
What did you say?
What's the truth? You've been around.
I'm going to kill you.
You gone crazy?
I'm going to kill you.
You ain't going to kill anybody, Red.
All I need is something to do it with.
Hey, come here. Redhead, put down that knife.
5 minutes ago, I used it to cut bread.
Ginny, if this is a gag, it's
now,
not really...
Now I'm going to use it to kill you.
You ain't going to kill anybody.
I loved you. Oh, how I loved you.
Ginny.
I said I was going to kill you.
Ginny, look what you did. I'm bleeding.
I'm going to kill you.
Don't, please. Please, don't.
I'm going to kill you. Kill you.
Somebody help me. What did I do? Redhead, what did I
Oh, that you, Jenny?
Yes, Daddy.
Well, concert over?
Yes, Daddy.
How was it?
All right.
I don't know. Why don't you have any luck with the fellas?
I have luck, but it's all bad.
You know, you get more beautiful every day. And that red hair. You look more and more like your mother.
Thank you.
You also smell kind of nice. Yeah, just like your mother.
It comes out of a bottle. I think I'd better get to bed.
Oh, I thought maybe you'd want to sit and talk.
Another time. I have early classes tomorrow. I have to teach the kids fractions.
Oh, yeah, sure. Okay. Uh-oh, I can tell by the way it rings. Somebody did something. Captain Turner. Who? Yeah. Well, how long ago? Where? Is the doctor now? Yeah, okay. Yeah, I'm on my way. I gotta go.
At this hour of the night?
We got a murder.
Oh? Who?
No great loss to anybody, some rock singer.
Daddy, even a rock singer is a human being. Who was he?
Oh, I don't think you'd know him, honey. He wasn't your kind of highbrow musician. Name was Lee, Bobby Lee Armature. You ever hear of him?
I don't think so.
Well, somebody cut him up. Multiple stab wounds.
Oh, how awful.
You better not wait up for me, Ginny. This could go late. Good night, honey.
Good night, Daddy.
Ginny, I know I was pretty tough on you while you were growing up and all. And the thing between me and your mother didn't help. But look at you now. I raised you right. You went to college. You got a job teaching school.
I'm grateful, Daddy.
No, I mean, you didn't turn out like the rest of them long-haired, hippie, foul-mouthed kids.
Well, he's dead now.
Oh, yeah. I better get rolling. I just wanted you to know I'm so proud of you, Jenny. What's your name?
Chunky Chapman.
What do you do?
What do I do? What do you do?
I am a captain of homicide detectives, and I understand you're the one who found the body. Is that right?
Ooh, absolutely.
That's your story, so let's not have any lip. Just answer.
Yes, call me Chunky. I play folk guitar. My last record sold 2 million.
What were you doing here?
Lee, he promised to send some chick over to see me.
For what reason?
Well, you know the score, Captain. You need to audition.
And?
Mm-hmm. She didn't show, so I called him on the phone. There's no answer, Dick. And I figure I better make the scene.
Look, you look like an American-born boy to me. Would you talk English?
Well, I get here and I ring the bell. Nothing. I can't figure it. He ain't supposed to go nowhere, but the door's open. I walk in and there he is, extremely dead.
And that's all you know?
Mm-hmm. Yeah. Figure I better buzz the fuzz.
That's how the room looked when you walked in?
Mm-hmm. Check.
You touch nothing?
Hey, man, I took in too many of those detective flicks. You know, you walk in where cat's just been cooled and you don't disturb nothing.
Yeah. And it was 10:30.
Yeah, and I checked the watch because I knew you'd ask.
Okay, you can take off.
You mean you don't want nothing else out of me?
Just let us know where we can get our hands on you.
Hey, that sounds like fun.
Millhouse. See, this citizen gets a ride home.
Good night, Captain.
Okay, what happened, Doc?
Yes, you can see multiple stab wounds. I'd call it a crime of passion.
Crime of passion? You doing my work in addition to your own, Doc?
Nothing was touched or taken. Diamond ring still on his fingers. Money's in his wallet. Tom, what you see here is anger. Anger, at least 10 wounds. Why so many? Somebody must have hated Mr. Bobby Lee Armature.
Where's the weapon, the knife? What'd the killer do with it?
I guess he took it with him.
No, I'd say she took it with her.
A woman? Why? Is this one of those famous Tom Turner flashes of insight?
There was a woman in this room.
How do you know?
How do I know? I can smell it.
Smell what?
The perfume.
Perfume?
Can't you smell it? It's very faint, but...
Well, now that you mention it, maybe I do. I never have noticed.
It's kind of familiar, too.
Familiar? How?
I don't know, Doc, but... I just have the feeling I ought to recognize it.
Tom... Tom, hey, what are you staring at? Tom, are you okay?
What is he staring at? Or is he staring at anything? Maybe he's just thinking. Trying to remember. Remember where he has encountered a certain perfume before. Well, if you've been paying attention... You can probably guess. And comes Act Two, you'll check your answer. They lead tragic lives, many of the modern troubadours. So many die young for a variety of reasons. Bobby Lee Armature was killed for one of the oldest reasons in the world, a woman's anger. And the young lady who killed him is no ordinary girl. Her father is the captain of detectives who's investigating the case.
Tom, you never cease to amaze me. Hard-boiled, two-fisted Tom Turner, who always gets his man, is now a connoisseur of perfume, of all things.
There was a woman in this room with him. A woman who wears this kind of perfume.
Well, it's a clue.
And I should recognize that perfume. I should.
Why?
I can't tell you, but... Doc, I'll bet my life on it. I know that perfume.
Morning, Daddy.
Hey, I see you got the coffee going.
You must have come home really late last night.
Yeah.
Well, there are some eggs if you want them.
No, I'm not hungry, honey.
I know. You don't eat, you don't sleep, you don't talk to people when you're on a case. So I better run along before I'm late.
Ginny.
Yes?
Ginny.
What is it, Daddy? Why are you looking at me like that?
Ginny, that perfume of yours...
What about my perfume?
What about it? Oh, nothing. I just happened to notice it.
You just happened to notice it? No. I've been wearing it for the past 3 years.
But this perfume of yours, I guess a lot of women wear it.
Oh, no, I don't think so. I never ran into anyone else who did.
What are you talking about?
Daddy, I have to run to school.
But where did you get this perfume?
In Cusco.
Cusco? Where's Cusco?
It's a city in Peru, capital of the ancient Inca Empire. Do you remember I went there to study Indian art?
Yeah, but I'm asking about the perfume.
Some little hole-in-the-wall company makes it. And I fell in love with it and bought a few bottles. This is the first time you ever mentioned it. Do you like it? Daddy? Daddy, what's the matter?
Ginny, are you saying that as far as you know, you might be the only person in all the U.S. who'd be wearing it?
Well, I would say that the chances of encountering anyone else who'd be wearing it around here are extremely remote. I can't get over this. Why did you notice it now?
Why did I notice it now? Because it's the perfume that was in that room where that punk singer was murdered, that's why. And it's not the kind of perfume that millions of women wear. It's your perfume. Yours, Chitty? Oh, maybe I'm crazy. I've got to be crazy. What can I be thinking of? Sorry to bust in on you this late, Doc.
Yeah, sit down, Tom. Have a drink?
No, I better not. Look, Doc, I got to talk to someone.
Talk away.
We've known each other how long? 30 years, huh? I I have to ask you a very personal question.
Hmm.
Doc, I don't know what to do.
About what?
I can bring in the killer in the Bobby Lee Armature murder.
Hey, Tom, that's something even for you. The boy isn't dead 3 hours yet, and there wasn't a clue in the room.
There was a clue.
Okay. Who's your killer?
Well, let's say at this point, a prime suspect.
Okay. Who? Well, Tom, who?
I can't tell you yet.
Okay, well, what can you tell me?
Doc, I got a little bottle of perfume here. I want you to smell it.
Well, why?
Because I'm asking you to.
Okay. It's kind of strange.
Strange?
By that, I mean it isn't usual. It's nice, though. It's nice.
You ever smell it before?
Did I ever smell it before? Well, I think so.
Where?
Well, it's familiar. I just can't seem to place it.
Last night at Bobby Lee Armature's room, there was a smell of perfume.
Right. That's it. That's the perfume.
Are you sure?
Oh, yes. Positive.
Is it possible that I could have made the suggestion and that you are simply accepting
No. There's no doubt about it. This is the perfume. This is what we detected in Bobby Lee Armature's room.
Doc.
Tom, what's the matter? You're pale as a ghost.
It's impossible. My daughter. My own daughter, Ginny. Oh, no, it's ridiculous. It's crazy. No, I'll go no further.
What, Tommy?
Louise? Is that you, Louise?
Yes, it's Louise.
No, how can you be talking to me? You're dead.
Are you going to bring in your own daughter, Tommy?
My own daughter?
Our daughter?
No. Besides, she can't be the one.
You know she's the one, Tommy.
No, Louise, no.
The speech you made to me when you went out and arrested my own
daughter. Oh, Louise,
A police officer has no feelings, no family, no favorites in the line of duty.
Oh, Louise, you...
You went out and you found the evidence.
Please.
And they hanged him. They hanged my brother, Jerry, who lived the life of a saint.
He was guilty.
Of what? Removing from the world a villain who brought sorrow and despair to all who knew him.
It was my job.
Then do your job again. Go find the evidence and hang your own daughter.
Louise!
You better eat some breakfast, Daddy.
Ginny, where were you the other night?
I told you, Dad. I went to this concert.
Well, I mean, did you go with anybody?
No. Why do you ask?
I was just sort of hoping you'd had a date.
Daddy, when I find an interesting boy...
No, I'm not pushing, honey. I just asked. I noticed your sweater hanging in the bathroom.
I washed it.
There's still a stain on the sleeve.
Oh? I must have been careless.
That's a bloodstain, Ginny. You better send it to the cleaners. They know what to do. You'll only ruin it.
All right. I'll do that.
How did you happen to get blood on your sweater?
Oh, I stopped off at the supermarket on my way home the other night. And they were having a sale on steaks. And I picked up this package. It was so badly wrapped that the blood must have...
Oh, that's how it happened.
I was so angry. I just stalked out of there without buying anything. It's such a pretty sweater, too.
Drop it off at the cleaners.
I will. How are you doing on the murder?
Huh? That's coming along, I guess.
Good. Well, I better be off, or I'll be late for my first class.
The perfume, and now blood on the sweater. Isn't that enough to make her a suspect?
No, it could all be coincidence.
Would it be coincidence if she were someone else's daughter?
Louise, I...
Now, if she were a stranger to you, what you do would be to show her picture to possible witnesses and make it a color picture that will show her red hair.
I can't do it, Louise.
Then resign from the department.
Oh, I can't quit.
Then do the job the city pays you for.
But I keep telling you over and over again, he was supposed to send me a check.
Who?
Well, he never said.
All right, give me some names.
I don't have any names. Look, Captain, chicks come in two groups, you dig? Now, like you walk out the stage door and there are the groupies at 2 and 3 deep. Now, you just take the one you want. You didn't even ask for her name.
Well, there have to be some names.
And then there's the private stock.
Yeah?
Yeah. Now, this is first class. See, nobody knows about the private stock. Not the writers, not the columnists, nobody. Because this is stuff that's too good to be made public. A guy keeps it for himself and his best friends, and that's what I was going to get.
And you don't know who this girl was.
Now I will never know.
I want you to look at this picture.
Yeah, sure. Hey, this has got to be the private stock.
What are you saying?
Hey, yeah, that's the one he was going to send over before he died.
How do you know?
He said, the redhead.
Well, how do you know it's this redhead?
Because I seen him with her once.
You've seen him with this girl?
Yeah, we're driving by in a car, you know, and I just caught a glimpse of that red hair.
You're positive?
Oh, I never forget a face. Especially if it's a chick.
Now, what can I do for you, Captain?
Mr. Miller, I want to talk to you about Bobby Lee Armature.
Well, what can I tell you?
He did all his broadcasts from your station here, didn't he?
Yeah, when he was in town, yeah.
I want you to look at this picture.
Yeah?
She looked familiar?
Listen, I'll tell you something. He was surrounded, constantly surrounded by all kinds of women, but... this one I remember. Now, you want to know why?
Yes.
The hair. That red hair.
The red hair. What do you want me to do, Louise?
Bring her in.
On what charge?
Suspicion of murder.
No, I don't have enough.
You brought my brother in on less.
And stood up in court.
So will.
What? Smell of perfume? It's gone from the room by now.
Witnesses.
What witnesses? They think they saw a girl with red hair. You know what a defense attorney could do with that?
The knife.
What knife?
The knife that killed him. Where is it?
We looked for it.
Did you?
The killer must have taken it with her and then... you know, throwing it away. We searched every sewer, every garbage bin, every...
Then she didn't throw it away. She still has it. Did you search our house?
Louise, she's your own daughter. Why are you trying to destroy her?
I can't destroy her, Tommy. Yourself destroyed her long ago, and you
see where he is. He has two women in his life. One is living, the other is dead. And both are beginning to give him more trouble than he can handle. The solution to this problem, however, does exist. And it will be handled in Act 3, which will be unfolded in just a few moments. Heal thyself. And we can also say, detective, discover thyself. This would seem to be the moral so far of our story. Proof, perhaps, that the solutions to most problems do not require long and distant journeys, but exist in so many cases close to home, and quite possibly in the home.
Doing anything, Tom? Hmm?
Oh, come on in, Doc. I was typing up a progress report on the Bobby Lee armature murder.
Well, don't let me disturb you.
It's a very short report. Oh, what are you doing here?
I had to see the chief, Tom. I'm worried about you.
Doc, I'm okay.
This thing that's bothering you.
What thing that's bothering me?
You want to talk about it?
Well, there's nothing to talk about.
Okay. Okay.
Tom.
Oh, no, Louise. What do you want? Why do you keep coming back?
They're beginning to notice.
What do you want?
There's one thing that will give you the proof you need.
What?
The knife.
No, we looked for the knife.
You know where the knife is. It can only be in the house, in her room.
Oh, I can't search her room.
You don't want to find the knife.
Well, I...
Because you don't want to believe what she's become.
Well, she's...
You want her to be the little girl who says, Daddy, dear... Proper little school teacher.
All right, that's enough, that's enough.
But you know what she's become, don't you? Private star.
No, I won't listen.
Daddy, I didn't expect you home for dinner tonight.
Well, I've got to take a night off sometime.
You look so tired. I wish I'd known before. You see, I promised to go to an art exhibit.
Oh, that's okay, Jenny.
He's a friend of the head of the art department at the school. Everybody will be there.
Okay, go ahead.
I won't be late.
It's okay.
Good night, Daddy dear.
I followed her. She left the house. She got into a car. Drove a few blocks... She stopped. She went into a phone booth. Then she came out and she headed downtown. She stopped finally at what we call Disco Row. A strip of joints along the waterfront, clip joints mostly. But the real in places, if that kind of thing appeals to you. She went inside. I followed her. She couldn't see me. The joint was so packed and so noisy, but I could see her. And then I saw him. He was sitting at a table surrounded by all the parasites that hang around these people. But he motioned for all of them to take off the minute he saw her. She sat down. I made my way over to the booth just behind them. And I listened.
Hey, when you said it was the redhead, I flipped.
Well, Chunky, you see, Lee phoned me. He said, I want you to go over and meet Chunky. I almost flipped, too.
Why didn't you show?
I don't have a head. He gave me the address, and you know, I forgot it.
The Imperial Hotel? How could you forget?
I could even forget my own name.
What is your name, huh?
You know something?
Huh?
I just forgot.
Well, I'll call you Redhead.
And you're Chunky Chapman. Hey, that's something.
Well, ain't bad. Hey, what do you do, Redhead?
I run around with Chunky Chipmunk. I mean, Chunky Chapman.
Hey, you're some Redhead.
Yeah.
Hey, it's a noisy joint, isn't it?
Yeah, I know a place where it's quiet.
What are we waiting for?
I followed them out. They got into her car. She drove to the Imperial Hotel. I went upstairs. My daughter. My little girl. What was I going to do? Could I go in there and beat his brains out? What good would that do? My little girl.
This is what she's become, Tom.
Oh, Louise, shut up.
Will that change anything?
Why?
You know why. Because of you, her uncle was hanged.
Don't say that.
This is what she's become. One day, she'll make sure you find out. That day may be here sooner than you think.
What day? What day are you talking about?
The day she'll let the whole world know who Detective Captain Tom Turner's daughter really is. Stop her.
How can I stop her?
The knife. Find the knife.
Doc, Daddy isn't home.
Yes, I know. I came to see you, Jenny. You have to help your father.
How?
Make him slow down.
Oh, he doesn't listen to me. He doesn't listen to anyone.
He has to. He's not young anymore. He's burning himself out. Something's troubling him.
What? What's troubling him? Doc? Is something wrong with you?
No, I'm all right.
Well, then why are you looking at me like that?
Ginny...
Doc? What's wrong? You sure you're okay?
Yes, I just happened to think of something. I have to be going. Hi, Tom.
Oh, hi, Doc.
Thought I'd drop by, take you to lunch.
No, I'm not hungry.
You see the ball game last night?
No.
How are things?
Doc, you're trying to tell me something, aren't you?
Yeah.
Well, so?
Well, I don't know how.
All right, then skip it.
I can't. Tom, it's Ginny, isn't it? Ginny was the girl in the room. Ginny killed him.
Yeah. How'd you know?
The same way you did. You caught it first. If it wasn't for you, I'd never have noticed it. The perfume.
Yeah. I don't know what to do.
Let's go home. Face her with it.
Can't.
Then I will.
Well, Daddy and Doc, do you want me to fix a little snack?
No thanks, Ginny. Your father has something to say to you.
What is it, Daddy?
Well, Ginny, Doc.
It's your place to say it, Tom.
To say what?
The best thing. The right thing. would be for you to walk down to the nearest police station, the one in Crown and Park. We'll drive you there, Doc and I, and you can give yourself up.
Give myself up? For what?
The murder of Bobby Lee Armature.
You're crazy.
No, you killed him.
You're crazy if you think I'll confess to it.
Ginny, please, listen.
Get lost.
Ginny.
I said get lost.
Ginny, it can only get worse.
You've got no proof, none.
I have, Ginny, I have.
There isn't any proof.
Oh, yes, there is. This.
Where did you get that knife?
It's the knife. It's got your fingerprints in blood.
You found it in my room. You had no right to search my room. You had no right.
Ginny.
I hate you.
You wanted me to find it.
You're crazy.
You could have thrown the knife away, hidden it where it could never be found.
Daddy.
You could have wiped the fingerprints off. Why didn't you wipe the fingerprints off? Fingerprints are all we have.
Daddy.
Without the fingerprints, we've nothing. Nothing. Well, I'm going to leave this knife on the table. Doc and I are going to walk out of the room. And you can decide if you want to take a rag and wipe off.
Daddy, please. What do you want me to do?
I want you to make peace with yourself. And with me.
Daddy, I'm so tired and so unhappy. Help me. Please help me.
Oh, yes, Ginny. Yes, dearest. I'll help you.
And he did, in the only way he could. She was booked and held. It was decided she needed psychiatric treatment, and she's still getting it. Some people may wonder, did the punishment fit the crime? I can't say, because we all see these things differently, don't we? But we can all agree on my returning in just a few moments. That flash of insight, that stab of recognition. Suddenly the whole world is revealed in a drop of water, in a burst of lightning. We see the truth at once, but we resist it. We need time to let it mature or to face its implications. However, here we have insights, revelations, bursts of lightning intuition 7 times each week. For your pleasure and edification. Our cast included Ian Martin, Catherine Byers, Earl Hammond, and Russell Horton. The entire production was under the direction of Hyman Brown. And now, a preview of our next tale, an ex-con.
Oh, let's say I was attracted to you because of your record, not in spite of it. Have you ever killed anybody, Matt? You don't have to worry about telling me. I won't repeat it.
No, I never did. Why are you so interested, Beth?
How would you like to make $10,000?
You know the answer to that. I'm just about flat broke.
I'm going out to Bromley to visit my father and stepmother over the weekend. I'll pay you $10,000 to come out with me and pretend to be my fiancé.
Well, that's pretty pleasant duty. What's the catch?
Well, there is one little thing. Sometime during the weekend, I want you to kill my stepmother.
This is E.G. Marshall inviting you to return to our Mystery Theater for another adventure in the macabre. Until next time, pleasant dreams.